locked in perpetual prayer. Keep trying, my friends. Won't budge.
Too heavy. Well now, how's my favorite god woken?
Ivan smiles and salutes.
As beautiful as always, if unwilling to whisk me away from this place. This part is gated off from the rest. Whoever's been
here rests the dwarven hero Bromley. She served Lucian the Divine with honor and cast out the demons that plagued the great woodlands. The implements of her heroism shall rest at the site of her victory. Here rests the dwarven hero Bromley. She served Lucian the Divine with honor and here rests the lizard hero Vidya. She served Lucian the Divine with great dignity and vanquished the strange beasts that arose from the primordial caverns of Reaper's Coast. The implements of her heroism shall rest at the site of her victory. Here rests the elven hero, Halla. He served Lucian the Divine with great vigor and defended the farmers who feed Reaper's Coast against... Here rests the human... Suddenly, the earth churns and buckles upwards in several places. Something, some things, are trying to rise to the surface.
Godwoken! You must fall! The God King demands it!
You must fall, so that we may rise!
Let your blood quench our roots so we may grow!
The covenant shall be fulfilled!
Haste steel, Godwoken!
Thank you. die, Godwoken.
Graves shall be yours now, Godwoken.
I'll yield to none.
King.
God King will return those he favors.
Reveal yourself.
Thank you.
were heroes. What happened to them? And what's this covenant?
The heroes of Driftwood lie at your feet, dead for good this time.
There must have been lower standards to be classed as a hero in times past.
Whatever this covenant is, it didn't bring them victory.
Most foreboding. When did heroes turn villains? And what is this covenant?
not a silent monk, but it seems just as blank.
The servant grumbles. Within the stone garden's walls, peace be thy immortal fortune, relieved of toil, free of indignity, until thou art called to serve.
Human graves, may the dead stay forever at rest.
The dog growls and bares its teeth at you in a wide, unsettling grin. You swear you see a worm emerge from its grey-pink gums, then burrow back in. Slobber drips from the dog's bared fangs. Where the driblets land, the soil bubbles. Slobber drips from the... Here lies the famous sea captain Horatio Rednose Bellwether, sailed the seas, at last found port. The dog growls and bares its teeth at you in a wide, The dog growls.
Come closer! I dare you!
He sniffs. He snarls.
I am death. There's no defying me.
The dog's growls intensify and transform into a rhythmic rasp that mimics laughter. You swear you see the ground behind him momentarily churn and tremble.
Oh, but the death you think you know is an illusion. Those who meet their true end are puppets. And I, their puppet master, your bones will dance for me. Not one step further. I know what you want here, but Canna's already laid claim to it. Ha! She calls herself master. I call her minion. Whatever name you choose, it is her hand that will wield it, not yours.
The dog raises its head to the stormy sky and howls. The earth beneath you vibrates, a dirge plucked on the strings of a rotting lute.
Necrotic troll, you are summoned. Crawl through the gate. The earth opens for thee.
The lizard hums tunelessly, not a melody exactly, but more of a meandering moan.
Ten spans under, humans slept. Ten spans up, the dwarves were kept. Lizards burned in lasting flame. elven trees towards skies did aim.
She looks to your left with one eye and to your right with the other.
It helps me remember. Remember where the dead go. Sometimes they don't stay where I put them. That's okay.
She smiles at you with the innocence of a newborn. The hum still throbs in her throat.
Keeping watch, tending the graves.
She returns to her humming. She flinches as you move closer.
No, no touching.
Her humming fades. The eerie silence lasts for several seconds.
Riker might get mad. He doesn't like it when someone touches his things.
She shivers and whispers.
Powerful sorcerer. Lives here, right in the garden. He can take the you from you. No brain, just body.
She points at her head.
The servants. They got nothing up there. Riker has it all now. They need to be freed. Only way. Kill Riker. The servants, so lost, chained by Sorcerer Riker, but they can still go home to the hall. Set them free.
The ensuing silence lasts for several seconds, until she picks up the melody once again and turns away.
What's on your mind? Pray speak.
The servant responds with
a scholar or mystic, no doubt, lost in a book while reality rushes. Which god hears his pleas, and what comfort could the dead find in his words? When the kingdom is decaying, what good is a king?
Leave their dead for the birds to consume. How barbaric.
The eagle glowers at you with one baleful eye. The eagle glowers at you balefully, with eyes like shiny little buttons. One manicured and beribboned claw shoots forth to claim the stringy offal before him. Stretching his neck forward, he peers closely at you.
Pretty eyes, eyes that see far.
The eagle's own eyes glitter with avarice. The eagle pecks free some choice lump of gristle from deep within the corpse. He swallows it whole, dark blood dripping from his beak and matting the fluffy feathers at his throat.
Master died, but Master told me what to do. All my life told me you are what you eat. So I do. I will become the master. Unless you are not the new master, are you? Think me an owl, a wren, a crow? I am an eagle. I know my place in this world. So
he ostentatiously fluffs up his feathers and turns back to his sordid repast.
Fierce and feminine, an age-old symbol of dwarven womanhood. What's this? I found something.
The plinth of the statue bears a series of deep, circular scratches upon its stone. The statue can be rotated. The statue rotates with little resistance. You crinkle. The sculpture looks impossibly heavy, yet turns with little effort. The statue rotates with little resistance.
What's this? I found...
The headless statue looms over you. Its plinth bears the same rotation scratches as its counterpart.
Too heavy.
Too heavy. Won't budge.
What's this? I found something.
These are lizard remains, but in the human section of the graveyard, something's amiss.
I've spotted something.
What's this? I found something.
The skeleton is old enough for flies to have eaten its flesh, though some of its owner's clothing the bones look properly intact, though its skull is askew, as if the skeleton is looking in a direction it shouldn't be able to. The belt may have been gnawed by rodents and reptiles, but the name engraved on its buckle is unmistakable. Victor. You see no blood or signs of struggle. The surrounding vegetation is green and healthy.
Here's one corpse that never got a proper burial.
The shaggy dog keeps his distance, wary eyes sizing you up as his hackles rise.
You run away! Everyone here run away! All run from something!
He cocks his head to one side, confusion and suspicion wrinkling up his fuzzy face.
I ran away from bad man. Very bad man. Man wanted to make me spider food. I know. I can sniff good and bad. Riker bad.
He paws a few tentative steps closer and sniffs all around you, nose wrinkling with concentration.
Some bad. Most good. Good enough. Good enough.
He bounds forwards and licks your face effusively, His breath stinks of graveyard clay and ancient bones. Immediately, you feel an allergic reaction developing on your cheek, hot red blotches spreading in an angry rash. The dog scurries away to sniff about the area, leaving you with his approval and an itchy face.
Run! Run! Run away!
Looks like this place has seen better days. Much better days. Everything is very dark, all of us. Everything is very dark all of a sudden. Everything is very dark all of a sudden. Everything is very dark all of a sudden.
Christine.
Everything is very dark all of a sudden. Everything is very dark all of a sudden. is mine. I'm ready.
Into the dark with you.
What's this? I found something.
Well now, how's my
family? Ivan smiles and salutes him.
Thank you.
Whoa! Ground's trembling, almost as bad as the Lady Vengeance on rough seas.
What should we do?
You tell me, Conway. Do I look like I've got any Voidwalker repellent on me?
Glad I asked.
An older couple is crouched behind a cart, exchanging sharp whispers.
They'll tear the place down!
They'll tear us down if we don't stay quiet.
Careful, eh? There's Void woken up yonder, in the farmhouse. Plenty of room for you here.
Aye, stay. But do keep quiet, the lot of you. Just hush, now.
Clear them out? Are you mad?
He's not mad, Conway. Look at him. Looks like he's our best shot at getting the farm back. Good luck, love. Take care of yourself against those nasties.
Be careful now. Those beasts are nothing to sneeze at. Keep your voice down.
You want me to be quiet? Then stop shushing me.
glory is mine.
Hurts, doesn't it? Thank you.
Prepare yourself.
Keep your voice down.
You... Any word, love? Did you really now? Well and truly?
Listen. It's... quiet. They're really gone.
Oh. Oh, Conway. We can go home.
Conway and Lynn pull you forward into a great, strong hug. Lynn kisses your cheek. Conway claps your back.
Conway, you still got Hanag's things. Someone like this would know what to do with them. Put them to good use. It's what she'd want.
That's right, Lynn. That's surely right. Here, take this. Dear friend of ours left them with us for safekeeping. I don't think she'll be back anytime soon.
Conway hefts a heavy sack toward you, head slightly tilted in a grateful bow.
Oh, Hanag. Such a sweet dear.
Sweet? That's one word for her. But she was a friend, anyway. A sorcerer. I'm not ashamed to say it. We tried to help her.
Everyone needs help sometimes. Especially when blummin' magisters are hunting you out with those dogs of theirs.
Well, but we didn't know she'd bring those beasts. We surely didn't know. Well, ain't no shame in being whoever you are. You'll be all right since all this blows over. And so will we.
I bet Hanag would want to meet you. She needs friends. She isn't bad. All this was just an accident.
When the Voidwoken came, she ran off in the direction of the Cloister Woods. It's true, she's a dear spirit. Just pushed too far, you know? You let us know if you meet her. Tell her we miss her. Tell her we're all right.
I've always been a fighter. I'll get through this. Thank you.
Thank you.
This Magister didn't die by a sword anyway. Something's afoot here.
Hurts, doesn't it? I'm ready. Thank you. hurts, doesn't it? This again?
Villagers. Some slain by Voidwoken, others perhaps not. What's this? I found something.
Careful now. That's a trap. Look out! I see a trap nearby.
Look out! I see a trap nearby. Careful now. That's a trap.
Go no further. We are at ritual. Do not go no further. We are at ritual. Do not disturb us. Enter then. Keep respect.
Three battle-weary elven warriors make ritual over the body of a fallen comrade. They're chanting low and fierce, the pain of their losses manifest in every word.
go no farther.
Blood to blood, earth to earth.
Go no further. We are at ritual. Enter then.
Three battle-weary elven warriors make ritual over the body of a fallen comrade. They're chanting low and fierce, the pain of their losses manifest in every word.
Go no further. We are at ritual. Enter then.
Blood to wood.
Three battle-weary elven warriors make ritual over the body of a fallen comrade. They're chanting low and fierce, the pain of their losses. Three battle-weary elven warriors make ritual over the body of a fallen comrade. They're chanting low and fierce, the pain of their losses manifest in every word. Three battle-weary elven warriors make ritual over the body of a fallen comrade. They're chanting low and fierce, the pain of their losses manifest in every word. Three battle-weary elven warriors make ritual over the body of a fallen comrade. They're chanting low and fierce, the pain of their losses manifest in every word. Three battle-weary elven warriors make ritual over the body of a fallen comrade. They're chanting low and fierce, the pain of their losses manifest in every word. Three battle-weary elven warriors make ritual over the body of a fallen comrade. They're chanting low and fierce, the pain of their losses manifest in every word.
Blood to earth, to wood, to birth. The blood of Sarius to this earth.
The tallest, strongest elf, whom you take to be the leader, considers you for a moment. She seems to give you the benefit of the doubt and turns back to the task in hand. She places the tip of a long-bladed spear on poor dead Sarius's chest bone.
Blood to earth.
Her companions reach out and grasp the spear, ready to plunge it into Sarius's heart. The leader gives you a curious look, then turns away.
Blood to earth.
Together, they plunge the blade deep into Sarius's heart, then twist three times in practiced motion. Blood flows freely to the ground, and Sarius's heart lies open to the world, neatly cut in four.
Blood to blood!
Each warrior plucks a piece of heart and places it in their mouth. Chewing solemnly, their leader looks to you to see what you will do. It tastes as raw heart meat will, with a subtle texture, slick with fast congealing blood. You feel instantly ill. The elven leader gives you a look of what you think might be approval.
Sarius is a warrior, proud and true. Blood to blood, earth to earth, wood to wood, birth to birth. Sarius becomes his tree. May Sarius take root.
The elves pick Sarius's bloody corpse from the ground. Tova looks to you, then shakes her head. You should not help. The elves send Sarius to his final resting place. His corpse rolls to a stop at the bottom of the pit. The elven leader stands and stares at her fallen comrade. Then she wipes away a tear and turns away. The tall elf stares into the pit with dry, bloodshot eyes, her face betraying no emotion. She does not turn toward you.
That is our business. I thank you for honoring Sarius, but perhaps it is best if you move on.
The tall elf stares into the
That is our business. I thank you for honoring Sarius. But perhaps it is best if you move on.
She nods and casts her gaze back into the pit where her comrade lies.
We lose too much. We lose our homes. We lose our safety. We lose each other.
She looks into your eyes, her face set in a fierce frown.
It is enough. No more. I do not doubt it. The void is too close. It pulls us all toward it. If we do not hold fast, we disappear inside it. You attempt to honor us during the ritual. You attempt to honor Sarius. You help remember him. But we need help still, or we perish here. Not only these people here, but all of us. I wonder if you honor us once more. It is something of great importance to me and to my people. Our home forests are gone. The great trees are cut to pieces. The memories inside them nearly lost. They become nothingness unless we find our Scion. Yes. There is nothing more important than a Scion. We lose our forests to poachers, to the fog, to the Divine Order. We lose each other to the wars. A Scion is our only hope to survive, to build again. And this Scion, she is...
Her voice catches in her throat.
She is my daughter. Her name is Sahela, and she is taken from us. That is why we come here. That is why we lose Sarius, to find her. If she is lost, if our Scion is lost, all our people are lost.
Her eyes narrow, her fists clench, and her mouth tightens to a thin line.
Do you know the Lone Wolves? Then you know the risk.
Heal your wounds. We need you standing.
We come here to get her back, to bring her home. She is everything to me. She is everything to us. You are the one. We come because of you. I thank you. But the Lone Wolves take her before we are there. You speak to her. You understand. You see what a gentle soul she is. You see how kind. She is not only a Scion, but a precious child. She cannot be lost. You honor us. I fear it is impossible for one of my kind to enter their base.
We need you standing.
They know we are here. They expect us. She is taken by their leader, a savage man named Roost Anlon. I do not know why, but I know she must return to me. If I lose her, I cannot lose her. We plan another assault. We cannot give up. It is better for us all to die than for Sahela to be lost. I only hope perhaps you find her before then. Good luck. Once all are well, once more we take the mill.
And kill the Lone Wolves all.
Bind that wound that it does not fester.
Bind that wound that it does not fester.
Once all are well, once more we take the mill.
And kill the lone wolves all.
Once all are well, once more we take the mill.
And kill the lone wolves all.
Bind that wound that it does not fester.
Once all are well, once more we take the mill.
And kill the lone wolves all.
Bind that wound that it does not fester.
Once all are well, once more we take the mill.
And kill the lone wolves all.
Bind that wound that it does not fester. Bind that wound that it does not fester. Heal your wounds. We need you standing.
Healed or not, I fight.
Heal your wounds. We need you standing.
Healed or not, I die.
Heal your wounds. We need you standing.
Healed or not, I fight.
Please, hurry. Anything you can find out. Anything you can do to bring her home. She cannot be lost.
Heal your wounds. We need you standing.
Healed or not, I fight.
Heal your wounds. We need you standing.
Healed or not, I fight.
Bind that wound that it does not fester. Heal your wounds. We need you standing.
Healed or not, I fight.
Bind that wound that it does not fester. Heal your wounds. We need you standing.
Healed or not, I fight.
Bind that wound that it does not fester. Bind that wound that it does not fester.
Once all are well, once more we take the mill.
And kill the lone wolves all.
Once all are well, once more we take the mill.
And kill the lone wolves all.
Once all are well, Once more, we take the mill.
And kill the lone wolves all.
Bind that wound that it does not fester.
Once all are well, once more we take the mill.
And kill the lone wolves all.
Heal your wounds. We need you standing.
Healed or not, I fight.